This looks like an ordinary campsite, but it's not. It's hacking in progress. What do you need for a decent international hacker meeting? A web server on the internet. A large campsite for 1500 hackers from all over the world. Big tents. Enough electricity. An FHQ, a field headquarter. A fast internet connection. Good technology logistics and many volunteers for organizing everything. Phone boxes. But do you really need them because you have internet and mobile phones? Anyway, they are nice and green. And a tombstone for Bill Gates. A what?
Well, I come from Helsingborg in Sweden, and well, we first found out about HIP on the net. It was from a mailing list. Well, it's the first time we have brought our computers out in tents and so on. It's rather fascinating to see it. It works, but it's some problems with moisture and so on. I left my big computer at home, and I just built a small 486 computer from some spare parts and put it in a suitcase and brought it down here. So it's nothing special at all about it.
My name is Joseph. Yes, Joseph von Perling. I'm from Hollywood, California. Here for Hacking in Progress 97.
Well, I'm one of the web girls of Holland, the Holland division.
One thing surprising is that there is a lot more girls connected to the internet down in Europe than in Sweden. So that was kind of a surprise when we got here. We didn't think there just we like a boys' camp or something like that.
Well, I think there definitely is something going on with the internet and women, because internet is communication. And women have been very good in communication from origin. So that's why I think that it's growing so fast now. And women are kind of discovering the net and this way of communication and freedom. And that's why I think we must be here. We must be here to help women to get connected. And once they are connected, there's no limits, I think.
Je maakt gewoon werk.
Ja. Ik ben Marcel uit Holland. Ik ben jetzt voor de tweede maal hier op de HIP. Ja, we komen hier voor andere Leute uit te zoeken en veel programma's uit te wechselen. En ook een beetje te hacken en codes te knacken en zo. Dat maken we jetzt niet zo veel, maar. En als het een beetje donker werd, dan vangen we het gewoon aan.
We come here to learn something about hacking, what it really is, and what the difference is between legal hacking and illegal hacking. We brought our own systems. We have a Big Tower Pentium system with 40 megabytes internal memory, color screen. We have a network card in it. We have a network connection here that connects us to the internet. We have a very high-speed connection. At the moment, so we try to keep it up that way.
Technik mitbringt fällt aus. Den ganzen Tag Technik um die Ohren. Warum soll man da hier noch welche mitbringen? Also brauchst du nur eine Freizeitbeschäftigung, um Stromausfällen, wenn die anderen Leute dann schreien und nicht wissen, was sie machen sollen, immer wieder nachzugucken, ob die logischen Fähigkeiten noch stimmen. Also ein Zauberwürfel raus und weitergearbeitet.
Well, I brought some recording equipment, and I brought hubs and routers and cabling and various networking connectivity devices. But I do that so much all the time that it's not so important to me to connect everything here. As well, if I do connect here and I start to connect with my other systems all over the world, some of the best snoopers are right here. and all of my passwords would be captured, and I'm sure I would be getting email from them saying, hey, look, we're watching everything you're doing. The people in the tent right across from me have already done this. They've trapped entire sessions of email and telnet with other people in the camp, and they've sent them email saying, look, you're being watched. This is probably not a good idea to connect everything here. But it's a good sharing of information.
We're doing the workshop about smart guards, and we really want people to gain knowledge about smart guards, because these days, if you look on the web, the only information about smart guards you'll find is either commercial or very technical for deep insiders. We're having these electronic purses, the chip knip and the chipper, which really screw up your privacy. There's absolutely no privacy. Everybody can see where you paid, at what time, for how much, things like that. And the funny thing about this is that not only the banks can see it, but also you can see it on your own chip knip, what you bought. You can see it on somebody else's chip knip. So in fact, you can even see how much money a retailer made in a week or something. I mean, it allows people to spy on each other. And well, I think that's wrong.
I think a year ago we had an Air Miles card to get points at the local grocery store. And they had set up a special company to...
Air Miles?
They had two companies, one company that would hold the customer data and one company that would hold the data about what a user, a customer would buy. And they set up this structure so it wouldn't be possible to combine those two. But it did happen, and resulting in... a loss of privacy. If I buy some milk at the grocery store, they will know.
People should know what's possible with chipknip, because banks don't tell us anything. They say, oh, it's just a purse, you can put money on it and pay with things. It's exactly the same like real coins, but it isn't.
People should, your name is on it.
Yeah, people should know that and make up their own mind to do what I want to use a chipknip and things like that. So that's where hackers come in. And they can show what's possible with all kinds of technology that wasn't anticipated or advertised. That's the way, at least I think, hackers should be politic, by not taking a stance themselves. Just investigate, report, and show what's around, and people can make up their own minds.
Awareness, because many people don't know.
Awareness.
They have to know that these issues are there.
I really want to have a chip knip, but not to pay with.
To play with, yeah.
To play with, yes.
Besides the decryption of data, the encryption is an important subject. The cypherpunks introduced their mission as a part of their several talks and workshops. Powerful encryption software is subject to military export restrictions in the United States. In order to legally export a new version of PGP, pretty good privacy, the source code had to be transformed into printed text. Thus, PGP could be exported legally as a book. Outside the US, the printed code was scanned and turned into software again by many volunteers.
So that when some government says, oh, you can't have encryption, you little citizens. You
go, excuse me, you've already got it, go away.
In the big tents, the three HIP days provided a comprehensive program of workshops and lectures on all sorts of internet and hacker issues. There were discussions about security matters and about virtual communities on the net, discussions about the free flow of data and censorship at tents. The tactical media network activists discussed the importance of organizing independent media forums. X's for All manager Rob Hornkreib slams unsolicited spam mail, which is ruthlessly spread by crafty marketing experts. An ever-growing flood of spam is clogging up internet. Rob declares war on spam.
Goodbye, Billy Boy!
We love you, Linux! We do! We love you, Linux! We do!
Was wir hier feiern, ist natürlich eigentlich der früher oder später Tod von Apple. Es wird zwar nicht so genannt, aber trotzdem ist es so, dass hier der Grabstein von Bill Gates eigentlich gefeiert wird, um nochmal Abschied zu nehmen von diesen frühen heroischen Geschichten aus der damaligen Zeit, der Zeit vom Hackertum, von den Garagenfirmen, so wie Apple, die kleinen Initiativen, die groß wurden. Und ja, das wird hier nochmal gefeiert. Ich glaube nicht, dass es eine große politische Aussage ist. Jetzt die Bewegung gegen Microsoft hat eigentlich überhaupt noch nicht angefangen. Ich glaube, wir müssen erst richtig in eine Diktatur von Microsoft leben, bevor das richtig anfängt und der Widerstand sich organisiert.
Where computer people meet, they naturally talk about operating systems. Here at HIP, Microsoft products don't have many friends. Members of the Macintosh cult discussed the chances for either survival or fall of their favorite system. Just recently, Microsoft bought a lot of Macintosh stock. Next to the tombstone, someone put up a wooden cross for Apple. Amiga friends are past the wailing wall stage. Although Amiga has officially been buried, some diehards still develop software for this system. Optimists even believe in resurrection.
First of all, we like to be here because we feel ourselves like a little bit of hackers. Not really hackers to hack other systems, but more like hacking our own systems. Trying to compile programs to make them run on our system as well as on other systems. Other systems are different than our own system, and that's fine to see. And secondly, we're here to participate in HIP, to hear speeches and more like the workshops over there. And it's kind of fun. Normally you're at home alone, reading your email, making email, or just chatting with IRC. And now we're all together. It's a social event, and that's very important for us. Furthermore, why we're here for Linux. We're the Dutch Linux user group, and we like to promote Linux and want to help other people with their systems. And that's the second reason why we're here. What is great about Linux? Linux is it's very different from other operating systems. It's a Unix, but it's not just Unix built by a company. It's Unix built by people like you and me, and they're making just their own part of the operating system, and all that together creates one big operating system. And all the code is free available. Everybody can modify the code, can add features to it. And that's very special about it, I think.
One of the members arranged the t-shirt for us, so that's why I'm wearing the t-shirt.
Can you please yes? Back? Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
We have t-shirts also. Who has the iguana t-shirt?
Time to...
Wie heeft er een iguana
t-shirt?
So the other side, that's a quite little one.
Iguana, independent Unix, independent user group of Unix.
Independent group of Unix
alikes and internet activists, yeah. Now we do just once a year something, and this year.
And as you notice, we don't know, we even don't know our own name.
It's a loose collection of people. We are with 30 people, and if you can come individually, but we are from Belgium, and we had it's been over the last 3 months an enormous amount of email about HIP, and so we brought a lot of stuff, and it grew bigger. Ivo, the guy with the blue hair had a page where you could put up who brought what, and it was a sort of a contents to bring the most, actually.
Well, if you come with such a large group, it has to be organized.
So we had to rent tents and seafood tables and what else, seafood drinks, everything. It's the seafood transport. We came here with a large van, so it takes a little time to organize it. We wanted to be here because it's only once in 4 years.
Mijn wampen komt van fan zien. Wat zal ik je erzählen? Dat T-shirt dat heb ik in Ghana in West-Afrika gekauft. Dat komt die grote bundel textiel uit Amerika, en Duitsland en de Nederlanden. Uit alle landen waar het bijzonder goed gaat, economisch gezien. En dat T-shirt had etwa 1 mark gekost. Hij is 1000 series of zoiets. En daar werd met gelachen met de education gelegd. Aber die West-Afrikaner die kunnen damit gar nicht leven, weil es so teuer ist für die Afrikaner, Education zu bekommen. Und deswegen haben sie gedacht, dass die Amerikaner eigentlich mit den West-Afrikanern gelächelt haben. Und die Leute, wovon ich am Straßenrand das T-Shirt gekauft habe, die hatten sich auch gestaunt, dass so eine dicke Weiße, die offensichtlich gar was gestudiert hat, zich dat T-shirt gekauft had. Maar ik ben stolz drauf. Komt waarschijnlijk uit Amerika. Dank je. Zo was? Ja, goed.
At the hacker meeting, sufficient supply of caffeine is crucial.
Het geheimnis van Jolt. Also, dat hier. America's most powerful cola. Ja, es ist nicht so sehr verboten, aber es ist schon ein eigenartiges Zeug. Es schmeckt überhaupt nicht, aber es hat trotzdem was. Ich glaube, es ist das richtige Cola eigentlich. Ne? Coca-Cola selbst hat all diese wirksamen Sachen einfach rausgeholt. Jolt ist eigentlich ziemlich offen und klar über die Zielsetzung dieses Getränkes und das auch, was das Geheimnis von Cola überhaupt ausmacht, nämlich Maximum Koffein, More Power. Und das kann Coca-Cola überhaupt nicht drauf schreiben. Das müssen sie immer verheimlichen. Coca-Cola hat ein großes Problem eigentlich, in der Öffentlichkeit klar zu machen, warum ihr Getränk so erfolgreich ist. Das darf man eigentlich nicht wissen und es ist ein Betriebsgeheimnis, aber eigentlich geht es den Leuten doch darum, dass es diese Wirkung hat. Und dieser Hacker-Trank ist eben offen und ja, man genießt es. Was kann man mehr sagen? Ich finde es super Zeug.
The sun is shining every day. Many people complain about the burning heat, which melts brains and hard drives. The Red Cross recommends protection against sunstroke.
My name is Mathilde Mupé. I come from Amsterdam and I'm an electronic artist working with hardware. And I took my collection of hardware residue, I don't know the English word, leftovers, to make some sun shelter because it's very, very dangerous here for nerds to walk around for the first time since years in broad sunlight.
Because of the heat, the NetTime mailing list refrains from heated discussions on NetCritique and prefers to go swimming instead.
When the idea of the HIP itself came up, there was of course a notice on the internet. And so I immediately mailed back that I would be volunteering.
So I thought, well, an observatory would be nice. And of course, if we can take pictures in any form and put pictures on the internet, so it would be a nice connection. Yesterday evening we saw the Andromeda Nebula, and I'm very anxious to see it in a long time exposure. All the things you can see are... I have to interrupt this.
One month before HIP, NASA's Pathfinder mission landed on Mars, and the cute Sojourner robot began sending pictures and data from Mars to the Earth. At HIP, the HIPCAR goes about. Many people work together to build it and to write the software. HIPCAR's wheels are provided by a converted electronic wheelchair. It can be moved via its interactive homepage on the World Wide Web. Its built-in camera and microphone transmit pictures and sounds to the internet.
The only difference between the car on Mars and this one is that this car is accessible to everyone who has internet, and everybody can drive this car. Unless, unfortunately, the Mars car only can be driven by the guys of NASA. That's the only difference, I guess. This is Mars of Holland, this terrain.
HIPCAR is equipped with a GPS receiver, which enables its position to be controlled quite precisely. If it tries to run away, it is brought back on course simply like a radio-controlled toy car.
Well, people can log into the webpage, chat with other people who are waiting for to drive the HIPCAR. They can draw a ticket to join a queue to drive the HIPCAR. When they finally have the ticket, it's their turn. They can drive the HIPCAR a few meters. And they can type some words, which are spoken by the speakers here, by using speech software.
WWXS4ALLNLJSVMK.
What did you say?
Not only HIPCAR broadcasts sounds and images from HIP, many TV stations and newspapers sent reporters. Also, many HIP participants brought video equipment, just like we did. Live web cameras constantly broadcast pictures from HIP to the internet. Digital City activists organized the HIP Online Journal.
The idea of the Digital City started a little bit before this first hackers conference here, 3-4 years ago. And then a lot of people were here on the HOE. They discussed the idea of having a virtual community, a public space, and that's exactly, you know, to have a free public space without overkill of commercial, where communication is a more central thing, where there's openness, so all kinds of people can participate and live in this virtual city. That was the idea, and that was of course very much also in tune with the hackers' culture and the hackers' ideology. And I think still that's very, very important for the digital city, although, you know, you can see everyone has grown a little bit older, and Access for All is a big company now actually, so it has, everyone has turned and tried to find their position in being independent and in the meantime play the bigger games. So in that sense we're not as innocent as 4 years ago.
Three days go by in a flash. We really enjoyed to be part of HIP 97.
We'll see you all in 2001.